Dan Meadish. We got your gaming news for Hot Topics, Hot Tweets, the spiciest meat.
Yes, and we're going to be presenting all the goodies that we've gathered, which we will discuss and hopefully argue. But luckily for all of you out there, we do have a lovely mute button to shut each other up if we need to for 30 seconds.
Yeah, okay, to be fair, we haven't really used it as of late.
No, we've been agreeing too much.
We have been.
I'll try to hate you today.
Yeah, our friendship ends right now. Remember, we like when you call us out when we're wrong and praise us when we're spitting truth. So let's get to it. To kick off our stories, we're going to start by taking a look at the path to becoming an esports pro. In traditional sports, you have an established path to becoming a pro. You have high school sports, college sports, and semi-professional leagues to become a baseball or football player, etc. But that's not the case in esports. There's currently no pipeline that guides a 10-year-old or even a 16-year-old down the path to esports stardom, apart from playing a lot of games and really getting lucky. So, Brody, do you think it's possible for a system to be established where a player can go from an amateur to a pro in esports? And I feel like you're going to use Rocket League as an example here because I feel like they might have the best system so far that I've seen.
How do we put this into 2 minutes? Because, like, ultimately off the bat, my answer without saying anything is going to be no. This is such a difficult esports, and this is why I've always said esports is not sports. They are inherently different beasts. You know, sports are not a product from a company. Sports are just a thing that humans do in the universe. We have a physics set that's already defined, you know, whoever was coded in the Matrix or God made it, it's there. No one can own the, you know, football or baseball in that, right?
It's not a company. We're going down a science path, but we're not there, Brody.
But with video games, a developer makes it, and that is their intellectual property, and they can say what happens with it. So someone can't just go out and make a leak. They have to consult with the developer that made that. And now, if that developer says no, now you don't have that leak, and there's less support because less people are just able to go out and do that. So I can't just make, you know, a league for my school. You know, if I'm the principal, I want to make a league for the school to compete with others. I can't just do that. Yep. I have to contact the person that owns that property.
Sure,
but it's way different than sports.
That's right, because from the top down, we have a publisher, right, that really owns all the property for everything, okay? Mm-hmm. So it's very difficult to actually make a path for this pro to get to that one specific game. If there are systems in school that, you know, train people on FPSs, on like different types of genres of things, and maybe there was like a school of thought for that, that might be a thing, but
there's
it's very difficult to set a path.
There.
Yeah, of course, there's going to be problems everywhere. This is why you're right. Sports and esports are really not the same thing at all because of the fact that these esports can kind of like pop up out of nowhere. Like
that's,
Apex Legends is like happening
and
now.
Die
and
out
die
of nowhere.
Out of nowhere. So they're really, to be fair, there needs to be something in place. To be fair, needs to be something in place to protect very skilled gamers, to train very skilled gamers in the things that they're skilled at. Yes, but I don't think it can be an inherent game overall because how can we have that? But the best system, honestly, though, I'm surprised Brody didn't mention it or talk more about it, is the relegation system that happens in Rocket League, because at least there is a system in place underneath the pros that say, hey, you form a team, you're here, you have to have enough points to get here. And there's at least
Marissa,
some kind of branching.
As much as I want to hear you talk about Rocket League, we have to move on. They're yelling at me in the air. I had to use it, and there's my mutes out of the way. In streaming news, Twitch is beginning to ban streamers who engage in reckless driving while streaming. Several IRL streamers reported that their channels have been given temporary bans because of their poor driving skills and for violating traffic laws. Reckless driving can be classified as a felony in some states in America, which obviously violates Twitch's terms of service. Now, Marissa, we've been watching some clips. I wanted to hear you, but we had to. The show must go on. But, you know, we've seen some clips. We even, in yesterday's episode, we saw a clip of someone almost running over pedestrians. You know, I think we can agree that, you know, it's great that they're, you know, banning reckless drivers.
Sure.
Do you think that they should be banning driving and streaming entirely?
That's hard to say because people do record themselves in their car a lot because, number one, the lighting is actual fire. If you're posting any kind of like selfie or video and there's a car and the phone is mounted or the camera is mounted on the dash and you're just being recorded that way, it is, though, very distracting. If you're looking over at the camera to like check yourself or just like to talk to the camera directly, it's such a distraction. I don't think that we should be having this at all. Obviously, people need to pay attention while they're driving. We were just talking about terrible drivers today, actually, with our director Blaine and Tyler as well, because like he almost got hit by his distraction driver. Honestly,
on my way to work today,
exactly,
a semi almost ran me off the road.
Okay, see, Brody, and I want you alive. I want you here, even though
I would like
you,
to be alive.
I also love you so much. Listen, I want you to stay alive too, and I feel like this stuff is so bad. This is just catering to the fact that like so many people are getting in accidents, so many people are dying from just being on their phones while driving, checking social or whatever it is. I don't think streaming while driving should be allowed just in general. Maybe I'm just being an a-hole because I don't do it and like it's cool, but
I'm glad that you said that, because literally yesterday I was streaming my drive. Now.
No, no, but you were not. But you were not recording yourself, though. You were recording the street in front of you.
That's true. So this is the thing. I had it mounted, and I didn't look at chat. I had a mic mounted here, so I didn't look at chat unless I was fully stopped or pulled over at a store or something.
Right.
And that's when I interacted with chat.
Okay, fine.
But the thing is, like, not everyone knows how to have that control, and they're going to be tempted to look down in that. So it's hard. Yeah. Do we have to cater now to the common denominator that doesn't know
then
how
to not
be
distracted?
Then
there needs to just be laws in place where you can have a camera mounted facing outward.
Okay.
You can't have any kind of screen in your car where you're checking something, you're looking at it. No, you can actually have your screen and your camera facing outward.
So yes or no? Should Twitch ban it for now until that gets placed?
It's not black or white. It's a totally gray area, and some people are just honestly idiot drivers. Like, some people are so skilled at driving that they can actually handle everything and still drive and maintain and look and see everything in the periphery. They can do that. But unfortunately, 90% of the drivers out there are actual trash.
Amen.
We're not in that, obviously, because we're very good at driving.
We're amazing.
No, okay, not fun with those, because I don't want anything to happen after when I'm driving home. All right, the World of Warcraft community is divided over Mythic Races. For reference, Mythic Races are events where different guilds race to see who can compete in a new raid on the hardest difficulty when they launch. Now, the guild method is accusing Red Bull of trying to get third-party ownership over the races through a new event featuring multiple guilds. Method wants to keep a community run, while Red Bull wants to bring it to a larger audience with more guilds participating.
So,
Brody.
Yeah.
Mythic Races have been a community organized event for 14 years, okay? So do you think that maybe its desire to be bigger outweighs the concern that Method is trying to keep it community run? This really sounds very FGC, by the way.
Yeah, the thing is, I feel like there's a little bit more legitimacy to the concerns here that the WoW community has, because to me, this is, sure, it could bring more streamers online because they want everyone streaming so that you can view all their views, and there were less people. So now there's going to be more WoW content out there that could push that up on the Twitch list, so more people may start tuning into WoW, which is obviously good for the community. But they can start doing that without the help of Red Bull, and it does feel like Red Bull is coming in just to give a bit of their own push to their brand, which of course, like, it's, you can't blame them.
Yeah.
But this can be done without the help of Red Bull right now. And it's like, there's so many logistical problems here. So they want to have everyone out at an event on the day that the patch is supposed to drop. What if the patch gets delayed by Blizzard? What if they don't put it out that day? And now all of a sudden you got a bunch of people sitting around in a warehouse being like, what do we do?
Yeah,
right?
But then wouldn't that be on Reddit too, if they're a part of it, to actually make it okay? Like, wouldn't that be on them? The onus is on them then?
Yeah,
if they're taking ownership?
I do almost see it as Red Bull trying to ingrain themselves in a bit of the WoW culture that's already established.
And what's wrong with that? What is wrong with that? You guys, this means money for you. This means money for you, for your guilds, for this whole scene. Like, why wouldn't you take this corporate sponsorship? I get that you want to keep it community-based. I understand that, for sure. Mm-hmm. But there's also an opportunity here to grow and bring in a new audience, and bring in people that have never even seen this before, and actually give it more legitimacy than it already has. That's what sponsors do. And a sponsor like Red Bull, yes, it's endemic already. It's not even like these sponsors are coming in from the outside. It's not like an insurance company or whatever. It's not State Farm just saying, hey, we want to take a part of this. No, like, Red Bull's been in esports for a minute. They're not going to try to taint what you've got going.
And I got nothing against Red Bull. It's just, I feel like maybe they need to offer a little bit more than just monetary value at the end of the day. Anyways, for our last story, Ubisoft is banning quests that players are creating in Assassin's Creed Odyssey. The quests have one thing in common. They offer lots of experience for doing nothing, allowing players to rapidly level up. Though the game is single player only, custom quests are shareable online. Ubisoft says that banning these kind of quests protects the integrity of the game. Marissa, do you think Ubisoft should be banning these quests? I mean, they put the tools out there. They put the tools out there for them, and now they're saying, no, you're exploiting it.
It's just like we just had a story about Ubisoft and Rainbow Six, right? We just had that happen because they're also
going
in
on this.
Yeah, they're going in a little bit. They're checking out the scene and they're realizing, you know what? We're not controlling this and we don't like it. I don't really like that. I feel like if their tools are there to be creative, let them be creative.
Put it into the tools.
Yeah.
Like, put a rule set into the tools. Make it so that they have to have a certain amount of events or a certain length for that quest to be able to give a certain level of experience. And then you eliminate people exploiting that, right? But if you already give them the tools, You can't really get mad at them.
Well, Tyler's saying one is multiplayer and one is single player.
But you can share them online.
So, like, is a single player then okay? Like, where is the line here? We can't take it all away.
You know why they want to take it away?
Tell me.
It's because you can buy experience and level ups in the game, and they don't want to lose out on that sweet, sweet cash.
Sweet money. It's all about the money. Yeah, I mean, that's, I mean, okay, fine. So can we fault them for that? They're a big company that they have to pay, and they have to pay all their employees and their developers, and their developers that made this.
They can pay their employees.
No, yeah, they can, but they need money to do that, right? So they need to be accruing money constantly, especially with big titles like this, right? They make them every year, blah, blah, blah. They still have a team of people to feed, and they have families to feed, and they need to worry about that. They're gonna do whatever they can to get the most money.
It comes down to the method of doing it. Instead of just going out and banning all these things that people have made, just make it so that they can't do that in the first place. Instead of, now you're allocating resources to trying to stop people from making these in the first place. Mm. People aren't gonna stop if there's still a way to make it, right? It's like, I get if you think, okay, we gotta make the money off this, we gotta, you know, min-max as much as we can off of this, then just make the tools so you can't do that. But don't get mad at people if they're gonna do that if you give them the tools to do that.
Yeah, I'm always surprised by the creativity of communities, right? Like, they
It work gamers are a creative bunch.
Mm, then don't give them tools.
It's
time to check in with streamers and clip it. Our first clip comes from TriHex, where one viewer expressed their disappointment that they can no longer watch a certain show.
I used to love this show. Shame it got canceled.
Hmm. Too vague. Bro, you're such a
Okay, so people that don't know, Pro Jared had a YouTube channel. I don't think he posted anymore. There was just a lot
Likely
of scandal
not.
That happened. Yeah, there was a scandal that happened earlier this year where it came out that he and his wife were splitting up, and then his wife actually posted, like, you know, and he said it was all mutual. She posted saying, it's absolutely not. He's cheating on me, and he's cheating on me with this person. He did this, this, and this, and a bunch of underage girls came forward showing photos that he had sent them in, like, weird cosplay stuff. Like, it was a whole, it was a scandal.
That should be the new Rick Roll.
The new Rickroll, yeah, is Pro Jared, basically. And then there was, like, a whole account, a YouTube account set up of just, like, people watching his subs go down, like, of people unfollowing him and unsubbing. Like, I mean, it's crazy how, like, the internet can turn on you, right? The internet can full-on turn on you. So I guess you just really have to watch what you do. Yeah, guys, like, why are you sending photos of things that it shouldn't be shared to people that maybe you might not trust a month from now? Like,
are you talking
be very
about my
careful.
Memes?
No, your memes are
My
fine,
memes,
but,
I said,
like,
you are
Brody,
great.
You need to stop sending dick pics to people. Like, that's something that you absolutely need to stop doing.
I
they
literally
will be
only send them to myself, and even I'm disappointed. Let's not talk about my genitals anymore and move on. How about that? Our next clip comes from Aries, who has some thoughts on Skyrim.
Whoa. Oh, he's cold. Now, what the f***? This game sucks like crazy. Oh my god! This game is so tight. Did you see what I just did?
How fast that turnaround. Have you ever had that quick change of mind where you're like, well, this is garbage, and then I was like, actually, I'm really good.
Yeah,
like
in
it.
Mario Kart, like every single time.
Yeah, every 2 seconds, the roller coaster of emotions that you go through.
Exactly.
It's like, yo, I'm in first place. This game's amazing. I'm actually really good. Oh, there's a blue shell, red shell.
Yeah,
there's another
trash.
Banana that I fell into after the red shell hit me.
Yeah, it's absolute garbage.
And you get knocked off the bridge.
Or like you're in eighth place or something, and then you get that circle, that ring of eight. Right?
Oh,
where
you're
everything, you're like, yeah, this game's the
you
best.
You feel powerful.
You just feel power. It's that. It's Mario Kart. And I guess Skyrim, too, because that happens all the time. All right. It truly is the best time of day when we scroll through the Twitterverse to bring you all the things the pros bless us with from their timeline. We especially love it when they remind us that we all do dumb things sometimes, Brody.
Why call me out?
Bio Frost says, I washed my hair with toothpaste thinking it was shampoo. Sigh.
What?
Okay, yeah.
How do you even do that?
Okay, well,
to be fair,
have you ever brushed your teeth in the shower before?
No.
Oh my gosh, it's so refreshing. It's super refreshing. Literally just put some toothpaste on your toothbrush, bring it into the shower with you, brush your teeth while you're in the shower. So refreshing.
You ever pooped in the shower?
No, that's totally different. This is
it's not
this
different.
Is getting clean. That's getting obviously dirty.
No,
so
you're
like
completely
see,
my insides.
See, I knew waffle stomped.
I've been framed.
Said no for the waffle stomp. Listen, the toothpaste brushing teeth in the shower is very refreshing. So I guess maybe he was really tired or something and he reached for shampoo. And he grabbed the toothpaste tube and he.
I don't know about you, but my shampoo bottle and toothpaste tube look entirely different. And you should probably be able to tell the second you pick that up.
And maybe he was just really tired or like on something.
Maybe he wanted to try something new and just like couldn't think of an excuse afterwards. Maybe
this
will refresh my hair. I don't know. I can't figure it out. Anyways, Overwatch Pro Apply is tweeting things that really speak to me as a man. The diameter of Pringle cans is way too small. Your truth. And one of my favorite comedians of all time, Bo Burnham, talked about on this as well. He made a whole song about this.
Oh, yeah?
He only wants to have a daughter just so she can put her hands in the Pringle can and get the last Pringles for him.
No, it does get difficult though. Like, I have lady hands. I can't, like, it's hard to get all the way. I don't want to make anything that can turn into a meme. So, just like, is it? There, just like that, stuff to get in there. Then you gotta, it's like this, nope, it was going a direction that I can't take back. So we're not gonna go there. Listen, sticking with Overwatch fam, Malik has some news. He says, I inhaled Beyonce's air last night. I held my breath and exhaled into small airtight baggies, selling each baggie for 500 racks per.
Oh my God, this is going
too
much.
Someone would buy that though.
Okay, so it's like, I like these parody ones. We saw the gamer bathwater.
Yes.
Yeah, there's clearly a parody. Nobody would buy that.
But
I actually could see someone buying this.
Somebody would buy that for sure.
You took in Beyonce's CO2 output as you were near her. It's like, that's going in a bag and...
Yeah, and just baggy it or just keep it forever. Yeah. Like, this belongs to
Beyonce. I own Beyonce's CO2.
Okay, but what's the most ridiculous celebrity thing that you would actually pay money for?
Probably not much, in all honesty.
I feel like if you got something from Chester...
The weirdest stuff, Elon Musk. Okay, I'd do anything for Elon
Musk. That's what I'm saying! you would take a baggie of his poop and waffle stomp it easy. You would do that. For sure. That says Brody Moore. That says Brody Waffle Stomp Moore if I've ever heard of anything else. Tell me I'm wrong.
I have no idea what to say after that. Can we move on?
Tell me I'm wrong.
You're a little wrong, but maybe not. I don't know. We'll see what the future holds. Let's move on because it is time to get to some crowd control. Our first clip is yet another great moment in GTA. Some days, no matter what you do to make sure you have a good day, it still falls apart. This guy feels. Mm. You try to dodge, oh hey, you drop this fire hydrant. I just love it. Straight to the face, no matter what, man. You try to get it out of the way of, you know, the world coming at you, and something else sideswipes you.
Yeah, that's just a lesson for life.
That's just big facts.
Also, like, apparently Mercury's in retrograde now, so that stuff's gonna happen.
Wait, what?
Mercury's in retrograde.
Excuse me?
I don't know, look it up, Brody. Okay, Mr. Science, can't you get into astrology too? I feel like
that's
you could go there.
Can I have another mute button? Astrology is not science. Jeez, no, help me.
What's your sign? Huh? You know it, don't lie. What's your actual sign? Tell me the truth.
What's next
you
in your
know
script?
It.
What's next in your script?
No, you know, I know you know it.
No. I'm not buying into
you
this.
You for sure know. Are you like Scorpio?
I know because you won't let me
are
not
you,
know it.
Are you Scorpio?
No.
What are you? Libra?
What do you think I am?
I don't know, I'm not.
Exactly, because
Cancer.
You can't tie personality to a
Cancer.
Sign.
I'm Leo, BT Debs. Yeah, sports have their armchair athletes and posers, but esports have their own version. We all know one. I present to you the esports guy.
I like to mix my Adderall with protein powder in the morning. I heard it on Joe Rogan's podcast. Helped it absorb into your body better. I've been playing insane ever since. You have no idea.
Yeah, I was drinking G Fuel way before it was cool. They were going to sponsor me and give me a discount code, but I don't know. I guess the offer got lost in the mail. I don't really complain too much, though, you know?
Look at him out there. Playing basketball. Big dreams.
I don't know why everybody makes a big deal about Shroud. I killed him. Yeah, clips on Twitter and everything.
Yeah, I remember whenever I used to play basketball. Probably would've went pro if I hadn't torn my rotator cuff sniping in PUBG.
What the f*** is that, Colin? Is that a pre-mixed energy drink? You know the rules. If it ain't a chalk, take a f***ing walk. Don't play that f***ing in this house.
Yeah, I know I'm supposed to change my Twitter name today, Mom, but I can't pick. I like FaZe more, but 100 Thieves feels like more of a family. Yes, when I change my Twitter, that means I'm a professional player.
Bruh, seriously, we all know someone that changes their Twitter handle to something like have like 100 Thieves or something in it.
Yeah.
It's like, what are you doing?
Yeah, like
you have 3 followers. I know you're not a part of that org. What are you doing?
I thought it was always a thing where they're just huge fans of that particular org, so that's why they put it in their handle.
But
guys, like that's really stupid. You're not actually a part of the org. You're just a fan of it. Like you could say 100 Thieves fan. or a green wall fan, but like you're not actually a part of it, like don't delude yourselves, okay? Like let's all live in a reality here.
Let's live in a reality. We play video games for a reason,
Marissa. No, but like outside
we
of the video game.
We try to escape reality.
Outside of the video game, we are living in the real world and let's behave as such, okay? Please.
Yes, fine. You know what?
Please.
I'll try for at least 5 minutes.
Okay. Thank you.
In case you missed it, Nintendo did announce the newest version of the Switch Lite. Now, if they follow the footsteps of the 3DS, you know more versions are coming. Mm. 2017, let's hit the, you know, we have our Switch. We got our Switch Lite. Then we got the Switch I. We saw that with the DSi.
Yeah, yeah.
The Switch iXL. Oh, how about the 2 Switch? Flatten it out. 2 Switch XL, you need a big one. Uh-huh. Nintendo Switch 1. Then we got the new Nintendo 2 Switch, 2 Switch XL, new Nintendo Switch 1 XL. Straight up. I will have to hand it to them. They destroy Microsoft in making very convoluted system names.
Yeah, absolutely. No, Nintendo wins the prize in that for sure. They also win the prize for, you know, best handhelds on the market. They know what they're doing. Like, yeah, they will put all these models out there. I'm sure half of those will actually come out.
Do you think that strategy is going to work again? I mean, I don't even know if it worked for them for the 3DS.
I didn't think it worked for them. It definitely worked for them for the 3DS, for sure, hands down. I owned a few of those, actually. But but for the 2DS, like, I didn't think that they would sell that. I honestly didn't. And they sold so many of those, too. So, I mean, they keep proving us wrong time and time again.
The point of the Switch is to have the portability and to share it with your friends.
Yes, and then it gets smaller and it gets lighter, and that's just the way she goes, bro.
I don't get it.
Listen, I don't get you sometimes, but I
Same.
Still love and appreciate
Fair.
You, right? No, I was kidding. You already muted me. You can't remember. That's it for I'm muted. Remember, you can always hit us up on our social. Just say hi or send us some stuff to react to. We are Squad State everywhere. We'll see you next time.